Is anybody, you guys are from where? Toronto?
Yeah, mm-hmm. Born in Toronto.
Toronto?
Yeah.
What about you?
Toronto.
So you would both say that Somali-Canadian?
Yeah.
Yes, but
so
then...
More likely Somali before I would say attached Canadian, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Just because Canadians don't consider me Canadian, so why would I want to...
Yeah, they do. Canadians are the nicest people in the world.
That's not true.
Are you crazy?
No, speak on it.
Speak on it. 1991, when the whole war was going on, Canada accepted us out by like the bunch. Everybody was so helpful, so nice.
Yeah.
How are you going to say Canadians? Like, come on, we're not America.
No.
Well, there's a big difference between Canadians and Americans that only North Americans understand.
But
right?
You also have to understand that the Canadian like immigration law also started to do DNA testing when Somali people were accepted into the country. So that's some sort of form of
racism.
And
asking your tribe.
And asking your tribe also to see what part of Somalia you were coming from. So nice enough that they were to welcome us in, but they were really like racial with it in regards to like defining what family was. And then also 1992 when they went to the UN peacekeeping mission in Somalia, it was the first failed peacekeeping mission because they were raping boys.
Operation Snatch Nignog?
Exactly, Operation Snatch Niggas. Niggas.
These are some of the guys from the unit which captured a 16-year-old Somali named Shadane Aron. And then gave him a command performance with fists, boots, lit cigarettes, and iron bars. Co-starring Master Corporal...
Yes, because they peed on him, too.
Yeah.
I remember that, guys, because that literally left an image in my head.
But that's like individual people doing sickening things.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That you're not going to see all of Canada doesn't like Somalians because that one time that some sickos went and raped children. Like,
right.
But no, but what the way that they defined it was a failed peacekeeping mission. They never really stipulated or explained why it was failed. It just seemed like we were just hard
to
work with.
Look at France. France had been accused of raping, I don't know, it was in Sudan, some other country that they tried to do a peace mission in where some of the army people, it happens all the time. There's sickos in every country in the world. Nothing I have against you, but I hate when people are like, oh, the Canadians or Americans don't like small people. My whole thing is up and leave.
But no, she doesn't rep, she said.
She's not
going
to hurt people,
but
Canadians don't like small people.
The question was, would you rep? So who, as you, as
but yourself,
you get
how in trouble,
do you want to identify
if you
yourself?
Get in trouble and you're in Timbuktu, okay,
right.
And you're looking for an embassy,
yeah,
exactly. Are you looking for Somalia? Are you looking for
Canadian.
Canada?
No,
you're going to say, I'm here.
It's a privilege.
Yeah,
and
we can't take advantage
Canadian.
Of that privilege, though.
No, it's definitely a privilege to be Canadian. That is absolutely true. But then if you were to say, for instance, you have a Canadian passport.
Yeah.
People ask you, where are you from?
You have a Canadian birth certificate.
And I have a Canadian birth certificate. They're asking me because it's the assumed notion that I'm not from there.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually am.
Yeah, but
right?
You answer, I'm from Canada. I'm Canadian.
Yeah, but it's like, no, but where are you really from, right? Which is a micro invalidation. So
yeah.
It's
that's,
just like,
that's anyone of color, though. You could be
but,
the Jamaican.
But again, like, even though they're saying it in such a polite way, it's still...
But is it
a
natural
ask.
For people to ask other people
I'm
where
not,
they're from?
I'm not totally
you're
offended.
White, let me ask
when
you something.
Ask
you,
me that.
Sorry, say that again.
I'm not totally offended when people ask me, oh, you know, what's your, are you Canadian? Yes, I'm Canadian. I speak English. Look at my accent. Right?
You're right.
But the thing is, after that, they might ask you, where are you from? Are you from like,
what's your
background? I get everything. I get Filipino, I get Spanish, I get Arab, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm from this and there. You know what I mean? But I'm not totally offended because sometimes people will ask you, as you're right, people will ask you because, like, no, you're not from, you know, you're not Canadian at all, you know?
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, they're actually genuinely curious, you know what I mean? So it's just, you don't know what their intention
do
is.
Do white people
heart,
get
you know?
This?
Nope.
Some white people get it too, though. I'm actually from France.
I bet
France,
you
white
people
are
in Africa,
Irish,
they'd be asked,
you know what I mean?
Where are you from? You know what I mean?
They
because
they're
the minority. I'm from Canada. Oh, I came here on a peace mission corps from Germany. It's because they're the minority. Since we're the minority here, it's natural for people to say, hey, where are you from?
And she sees that as being invalidated.
It's a micro-invalidation.
Maybe not where you're from, but what's your background? It's a better way of wording it.
Yeah.
But. No, but if the question is, like, where are you from? And you're like, oh, I'm Canadian, and it stops there, cool. But when it keeps persisting because they know Canadian, really, where are you from? And the term Canada or Canadian is not sufficient for them, then like.
Can I say I do that though? Like, I'm gonna throw myself under the bus for a second.
Yeah.
When I meet a black person,
black too, you know.
black like me. Like, I'm not saying I'm not black. I'm saying another black person,
okay,
right?
Yeah, yeah.
And so I'm like, hey, what's up? And his name is like, you know.
Yeah,
or something, and I'm like, yo, where are you from? Like, I'm genuinely curious, and he's like, oh, I'm from Manitoba, and I'm like, okay, but for real, where are you from? Like, that's like, I just want to know, like,
your
I just want to eat, like,
what language
do
your parents speak?
That's
yeah.
But to me, I feel like it's just
poor way of like asking the question. Like if the person next question was like, what's your ethnic background? You'd be less offended.
Yeah.
Right? So I think people just speak lazy. No, no, there are some people that are like just ignorant racist that can't believe you're Canadian. But other people like Queen Bukhari are like, I don't think you're racist.
Yeah.
But when you ask like, but no, where are you really from?
Yeah.
It's just a lazy way of saying like, what's your ethnic?
That's
a proper, more politically correct way of saying.
I'm
not trying to be offensive.
Right,
but people fall in two categories. Some people are trying to like, you know, discredit you, but other people are just like lazy. They're just like, where are you really from?
It was only now that Tim Hortons started including like people of color in the commercials, so.
Aisha was so.
Well, they better. What the hell?
Yeah.
You know who works there? Like, guys, I'm not generalizing either, but you gotta represent like the reality of who actually works at Tim Hortons.
Well, Canada, it's a bunch of white people playing hockey saying, this is the Canadian lifestyle, so let's keep it real.
Curling is
really you know what? There was a time when I was like kind of, I didn't want to say I was Somali.
Did you?
Yeah.
So that's
he looks like the type that would, though. He looks like that type that would.
Can you expand on that?
You know why? I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. Sometimes, for example, I grew up in the hood, okay? I grew up in Rexdale, you know what I mean? And it's like, the Somali in that area would probably be having, like, you know, some drugs on him. Probably have some, you know, might have a gun or something. Like, police, where are you from? Like, the last thing I would say is I'm Somali, because the last five people he arrested are probably Somali, you know what I mean?
Okay.
But now, as an adult man, I say I'm Somali, and people are like, really? I'm like, yeah, I'm Somali. Isn't that awesome? And they're like, whoa, you guys are not idiots? Yeah. Look at me. You know what I mean? That's how it is right now.
They're
so
repping
I'm,
it.
I'm okay with that now.
Yeah. Has anybody, let me ask you, going off on that, first of all, I don't know why you came at him. Because you said
he looks like
the
type that would.
Why is
your
problems?
You like. On that note, has anybody ever not repped it? Like, have you, I wouldn't say lied, but was kind of like, meh.
I've seen that.
You know, somebody asked you and you were like,
but,
mm.
I've never denied somebody. Some guys have come to me and they're like, Habusha? Habusha?
Habusha?
And they start talking to me. So I'm like, I'm in a rush.
Salam
I'm like, yeah, you done. Yeah, you done. No.
Yeah.
Habusha? Or I've actually had Somali people come up to me and say, my Ethiopian queen.
Yeah.
I'm like, what are you, shut up. Like, you're so corny.
But
like,
has anybody else point blank said, like, nah, I'm not Somali?
I've seen it happen in front of me in night school one time.
Yeah?
Night school.
Yeah, there were some Bengali guys that had problems with one of my friends. So we're at the bus stop. And they're talking shit. One guy comes, and he's from Brampton.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know what he's doing in Ottawa, but he just comes. He's like, yo, you guys Somali? And one dude that was right beside us, nah, man, I'm Ethiopian. He started walking away. He got nervous. And I know this guy, we played ball together. I looked at him, yo, you're fired, bro. Like, don't ever hang around me again. We have problems.
Yeah.
So you guys are like, who's Somali? Yeah, we're Somali. You guys, anyway, that's another story.
Yeah.
But I witnessed that, and that was cowardice.
Yeah.
No,
I've only done it.
That's a witness. You got to keep them around.
I've only done it a couple of times where I look very Somali. I know I'm not on camera, but you guys could tell. I look Somali. And the only time I've done it is to save my own life. Like, it was for a life-threatening situation. Okay, so this is a whole nother topic. We'll have a whole nother discussion about this. But Somali men, when they hit on you sometimes on the street, they can be a little aggressive. Some Somali men can be a little aggressive. So whenever
like
dudes
it.
Are like, yo, naya, I'm going to holler at you for a minute. I have to holler. Da, da, da. And they grab your arm and a headlock or whatever the case may be. I'm not like, I've been in a situation. What I have in my head. This is like literally, I'm going, what are you telling me?
You're very aggressive men, it's true. Where are you going?
Yeah, yo, I short of
I know you from high school and everything.
At that point in time, they're like, yeah, got it. But actually, though, like, and then so because they think because we have that connection of being a Somali, you know, a Somali sister and a brother, whatever,
yeah.
I have to speak to them, right? So at that point in time, I'm fearing for my life. So I straight up, I'm like, no. I'm Colombian. Like, I don't
oh my God.
Colombiana, right?
Say,
yeah.
So but whatever the case may be, I don't know about Somali. It's just
American.
Strictly for my safety, guys.
Yeah,
and that's the only time I've done it. And that's it. Like, other than that, I love repping it. But
exactly.
When it comes to your safety, shit, I'm Cuban. I don't care. Like, I'm repping, and I'm Cambodian. I don't care.
I was
claimed
Dominican at a Latino party.
You said Dominican?
Yeah, but that was just a blend and, like, kind of, you know, see what's going on for real.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean?
All right. Thanks so much, guys. We're going to move on. Some of us, we all have different opinions. Halima, you have been completely quiet on this. I'm going to give you a chance. go.
But subhanAllah, I've never been put in a predicament. I never like occupying space that's not mine. Like, I've never been put in a predicament where I was asked, are you like Somali or like, what are you? No, alhamdulillah. I think I have more of a difficulty with my faith than I do like my heritage and my ethnicity.
Yeah.
And alhamdulillah, yeah, I've never been put
so
in
a predicament. So somebody has asked you like, hey, where are you from? What do you say?
Alhamdulillah, I say I'm Somali, and Allah has never brought me people who just keep persistently asking more questions.
Yeah.
Or
you don't get hollered at like, Naya Kali, Bakurahullah, like, my bad, is it just my space that I'm in?
What kind of guys approach you? Where do you hang out?
Guys, I live downtown, by the way, downtown Toronto, in Caravana. Couple of years ago, I live downtown, so I can't even, like, in order for me to go to work on a Caravana day, or whatever the case may be, or even go grab snack from the corner store, I'm in that core. And so, the gentlemen that are occupying this core during the time of Caravana, some of them make some, guys, I'm not generalizing, some may be Somali. Mm-hmm. So all I'm saying is that, like,
you know
I have the sake of my life, like, I have to deny.
It's funny, it's Somali guys from Toronto claiming to be from the States all the time.
Yeah.
Yo, ma. What are you?
Yeah.
I just saw you on Regent, on Parliament, like, 2 weeks ago. Shut up. You know what I mean? Why are you claiming? You can't even cross the border.
Yeah.
Like, shut up.
I'm sorry, Halima. Yeah, so you have never had to deny it. It seems like you've never been in that space.
Yeah, no, never. Alhamdulillah.
Okay. Alhamdulillah, that's wonderful.
Yeah.
I haven't been so lucky. So we're moving on with that, guys. We're going to go to our next topic, and we will be back.